Hi, I'm Lara Argento, Automation Engineer at Automation Anywhere. I've been building bots for a few years now, and I get a lot of questions from people that want to know more about the world of RPA. So here are my top 5 questions I get from aspiring developers. So what do you use RPA for? It's not just automating stuff. It's understanding a process and even improving it and then automating it. You use RPA to streamline digital tasks by removing the bottlenecks. This improves day-to-day activities of a company from the convenience of a cloud-native platform. That's why I like Automation 360, because security is ingrained within every aspect of the platform. So another question I get is, what degree or skill levels do I need to start coding for RPA? And I always say RPA is for everyone. There are no degree or coding skills that are required for you to get started with RPA. You may identify yourself with one of these two tiers of developers. One being citizen developer, which is ARI or digital assistant, low code or no code. And the second one is RPA developers. If you do have coding skills, RPA can definitely make use of them. But no matter which skill level you are, RPA is for everyone. It's an amazing technology that is easy to use, drag and drop, and is going to have a positive impact by removing mundane tasks no matter where you are in the world. So visit Automation Anywhere University. There are great courses there, and see which one matches your skill level. So how do I improve my bot building skills? Work your way from the flow view, which is a graphic view, to the list view, which is a more code-like approach in the RPA workspace. Don't stay in your comfort zone. Try to do things a different way. There are different ways that you can do the same thing. Find a bot building buddy to compare code and approaches on how a bot is built. Read the developer portal and read the docs. Do your homework. The docs are really important and they have everything you need to know. Experiment with new packages. Take a look at the bot store for new ideas that are already tasks ready for you there. Post on a people, that is a user community where you can post questions and get answers from other developers. And most of all, practice and you'll get better with time. What are bots made of? So people ask me, are the bots made just of Python scripts? And the answer is no. The bots are made directly within the Automation 360 platform, which is an easy to use drag and drop development workbench. You can use Python scripts and even VB scripts, JavaScript, and even C# DLLs directly within your bot. If you want to take things even further, you can use the Automation 360 SDK package to build packages in Java, which can even extend your bot building capabilities and enable you to share those custom packages with other developers. So what is intelligent automation? Intelligent automation is RPA on steroids, is injecting traditional RPA with AI tech. AI-powered bots leverage technologies like NPL, OCR, and ML to continuously improve. With intelligent automation, we have every business process now being a candidate for automation. Basically allows you to go beyond the rule task-based automation. Things like dark data and unstructured data like PDFs and stuff that can't be easily captured can now be automated thanks to the intelligent automation, the steroids. This actually goes back to our first question. See how we're not just automating stuff, we're improving them and then automating it. Yeah, so this is what we're talking about. With traditional RPA, we're automating human actions to reduce errors and improve efficiency. Now, with intelligent automation, we're actually improving and automating human decision-making. These have been the top 5 questions I get all the time about RPA. Do you have any questions that we didn't cover today? Comment them or send them to my Twitter. Thank you, and I'll see you next time with more pro tips. Obrigada, ciao, ciao.